Welcome back to all you awesome model loving people. This one's had me excited since I showed it in the last new kits video. It just looks so cool. It is Revell USA's 1939 Chevy Sedan delivery. Delivery vehicles just look awesome, especially when they're customized like this. Check out those cool wheels on there. We got some barrels. We got some Kentucky Barrel Companies. Definitely looks like a moonshiner's rig. This is 1/24th scale, skill level 4. It has 97 parts in the box. So let's take a look at those 97 parts and see what we can see. On this sheet here, or on this sprue here, we've got all white plastic in the kit. They are cylinder heads. We've got some nice headers on there. All molded as one, but you can definitely make those look nice. We got the headlight buckets with their little mounting tabs on there. We've got a firewall, very basic. Two carburetors, and I want you to see the detail on those carburetors is really, really nice. And the radiator on that sprue. On this one over here, we've got our front suspension, our leaf springs all as one. We got a very stock-ish steering wheel, belt drive, wheel backs. We got our engine and transmission package. We've got a dashboard here with some nice detail on it. Strong detail. We've got what looks like an opening rear door. Sweet, we got functionality. Yep, we got some hinges and stuff. We got a fan with pulley behind it. We've got, I'm guessing, some interior seating with that cool beaded upholstery. Nice. On the last individual tree, remember there's only 97 parts, not going to be 400 trees in this thing. We got the full frame with the rear exhaust molded in. Definitely got some glass packs there. Can paint them any color you want. Technically, you know, usually they're red, but doesn't mean they're always red. We got a visor, so that means the visor is an option, but what 39 cents? I mean, it would look so cool with the visor. Got our rear suspension, driveline, drive shaft, 4 shocks, radiator line, some very, very skinny late 80s, early 90s style seats in this thing. I'm not sure when this kit was released, but based on the wheels and these type of interior touches, I'm going to say 80s, early 90s. Definitely fits the part. Then we'll bring out one large set of parts here, all at one, just so you can see how nice the fit and finish is right out of the box. That's the body and the hood over the fenders. We'll take the hood off, nicely shaped. It's a nice rigid plastic Revell's been using. I'm not sure where it's from, but it is rigid, and it takes to glue so nice. When you glue these things together, they just work. I mean, they're sweet. Got our body shell here. You can see all the sedan delivery has that blocked in with sheet metal. Definitely have an opening door option, so you're going to be able to see that interior when you get done. All the way around. Panel lines, you might want to engrave the doors a little more, but to me, they look fine to me. Got all, now be careful with all these moldings around here. Now, of course, you could do those in chrome. You could do those in body color. This is a full custom rig, so don't let anyone say you can't do it your way. In the body shell here, we have a carpeted interior all the way through. We've got our 3 pedals molded in. Nice. I mean, this is cool. We can really work on this, get this painted, detail it to our heart's content. We got our running boards here. Underneath, full panel design. Oh, I saw a trademark Revell 2001, so I was way off. This kit's only been out since 2001. Here I thought it was much older. No wonder it fits so nice and looks so awesome. Let's switch sides of the desk. What do we have over there? Well, we've got those whiskey barrels. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but this looks similar to the tree that is inside the old beer wagon kit, the old Tom Daniel kit. So let me know if that's the same ones. They sure look similar, and they come out looking very nice. They have very, very nice. They've even got bungs in the top. I said bung. So that's that. We got wood grain. We got straps on there. Those will be fun to detail. They went out to their tire tree, snapped off another amount for us. There's only 4 tires in the kit. There's no extras or anything. Nice tread pattern on there. Those look like a BF Goodrich tread pattern, but we'll see. to me. It says so on the box. It says Radial TA BF Goodrich on there. We've got a clear parts tree, glass all the way around, rear door. This must be for some options that aren't in the kit. Maybe you can cut stuff out. Looks like an optional sunroof. We got our front glass. Another windshield. Definitely a tree using another kit as well. So that's kind of neat to see what kit that would be for. On this tree here, we've got those sweet looking wheels. I will show you in this video how I will spray these and make these look like actual aluminum wheels without having to, you know, totally strip and repaint anything. Nice intake on there. The grille looks great. Black wash in there will do wonders. We got headlight parts on there. We got a little side mirror, custom valve covers, shifter, license plate frames all over the place. We got that hood ornament. We got two hood ornaments. We got the big bird, and we got the more streamlined one. They both will fit into the hood like that. So a lot of options on the chrome tree. What else is in here? We've got a gorgeous decal sheet. We got centers. We got gauge options. We got two gauge options. Check that out. More of a classic and a very modern. We've got Rip Beer logos. We've got Kentucky Barrel in two different style logos. There we go. BF Goodrich Radial TA tire decals, Rip Beers. We've got scroll work for the fenders and the sides. Pop's Ice Cream Shop. Those are really cool for any build. Oh yeah, decal sheet, knocking it out of the park. It's got a standard, what I call Revellogram, Revell slash monogram, full paint and color guide on there if you want to follow their ideas. Otherwise, customize it yourself, paint it up yourself, build your models for you, and do it your way, which is exactly what I'm going to start gluing together right now. Welcome, welcome, welcome back. Now, the fits are so nice, you'd want to build this kit twice, two, three, four times. So far, everything just goes where it should and stays, even hinging the doors. Aside from dealing with the smaller size of the hinge, everything is going together, and I don't know what kind of styrene Revell uses nowadays, but it really does take to glue. I mean, I use Plastruct bonding, and you just touch it, and it just melts and welds together. It's super, super nice glue. I've noticed that with some other kits as well, the more modern kits, whatever kind of styrene they're using nowadays on a lot of stuff, it just really holds together. So anyways, we got the rear door here. That will be painted and then put in place on the vehicle, and it should operate when we're done. We've got all five barrels done. These should be easy to paint because I will just use some stickum to hold these to a paint board and spray them and then detail and do the banding. The banding will take a while because you got to kind of turn it in your hand. I'll see if I can stick it to something or maybe drill a hole in the bottom and put a rod in there, and then I can turn it while I paint those bands and stuff like that. So we've got those all done. If you don't use the rear seats, I think you could glue all five inside and then see them when the door is open, like a root beer or a whiskey barrel delivery company. So we'll see how that goes. Got the differential, just cut it free from its trees, and then we can just hang on to the front of the drive shaft or hang on to one of the studs and paint that up. I'm not going to do too much detailing under the vehicle. This one is all show, you know, on top. Got the shocks separately. And the radiator hose, I'll paint those, detail those, and I can glue those on later, just for a little bit of extra detail underneath, but not going too far. Got the seats in here. I'm going to paint and detail these. I don't know if I'm going to use them or not, but we'll get them painted up just in case I decide to. We got this front seats all glued together. Going to need to use those, or no one can drive it anywhere, so it would look kind of weird. Got the dashboard on its own tree, so I can paint it in a complementary color to the body. Got our fan. Definitely looks like an aluminum performance fan, so I want to paint this separately, detail it, and then attach it to the engine when I get to that point. We've got the headers, the alternator, and the carburetors, so I may clip this and do these all in one metallic tone. I may do them in separate metallic tones. It depends on how I feel when I get over to the paint area. And, you know, I like to play things by ear and just decide as I go. I do plan on using the visor. I think these are very attractive. The molding is very strong on these parts, so I will be able to chrome the edges and chrome the center and get that installed. I think that's going to look nice and tight. And then we've got our wheel backs and our very basic steering wheel. I will detail that lightly and install that on the dashboard. I did find out by going through the instructions that this is the stock windshield that we'll be using. This is for the back door. These parts here are obviously for other models that are not in this kit. And then we've got our headlights and an optional sunroof. The sunroof has a nice rim around it with little rivets on it and everything. And as we take the hood off, which doesn't need any work, as we remove this, because this stuff fits so well together, as we remove the body, we can see underneath that you could cut out and place a nice sunroof in the top. So if you want to do that, you can. I glued the firewall in place so I can get it painted with the body color. I glued the taillight in place, the taillight mount and the license plate mount, because I wanted it joined in there. I did not want to muss up my paint job later. That can easily be painted with the body and worked on. So it's a big enough piece that we shouldn't have to worry about breaking it off at all. And then I know it's on perfectly straight with the model glue. I attached my hinges for the door so we can get those painted up with the body, and then the door will just snap into those as we go. So the body is set to go, or the upper part of the body. The lower part of the body, look how nice that just, with these ridges here, drops right onto the frame. Glued my headlights on. Again, I can get those painted in body color. The chrome trim ring and the headlight glass will attach later to accent those. And then we can work on our interior pieces, work on our running boards if we don't want them in body color. We can work on those and detail everything up and then just start placing parts on it and gluing things in place and make it look really sharp. We got the chassis here. You can see how nice that 427 fits in there. No issues at all. Just drops right in. pull that out. I did glue on this belt and pulley system. It is keyed on there. I'll be painting up the fan anyways, and when I'm hand painting my details on the engine, I can just give this a quick black for the belt and pulley, then attach my alternator, then attach that cool looking aluminum fan on the front. I did glue the chrome intake on there. I want to paint that by hand, then attach my valve covers, got the magneto attached to the back, and that is a nice looking 427 that's very easy to build. The chassis doesn't take much work. Since I want to place, or I want to be able to paint the exhaust and the fuel tank, I left the differential off the back, but that will join on later. Otherwise, I would have put it on, but it would have made it a hair more difficult to paint. Not that much, but hey, since it fits on so nice, I can leave it off and really get in here and accent things. Then we've got our front suspension. Nothing I need to reach underneath here, so I can paint that. And our radiator, I'll be doing a black frame, basic, glossing it up. Glued the radiator on just so it holds nice and solidly. I don't think it would have any fit issues later. The other parts of the chrome tree, all these parts here, I'm going to be spraying some material on it and black washing. The riser for the carburetors or the spacer. The wheels, definitely, because these are very sharp, but I don't want them to be chrome. And then the grille, I don't want the grille chrome either in my look. And that is it, the rest of the chrome pieces. The additional fog lights on the bumper, the accents for the front end, all that kind of stuff we'll just leave as chrome, and I won't mess with it too much. So I'm going to start throwing paint at everything, and I'll see you over there.
Bye.
As it sits, she is starting to look pretty tough. This is the body set on the frame, the chassis, the fenders, with nothing else. Now, I didn't do anything with these runners. I don't know if I'm going to. You could paint them black, but if I want this to be like a show vehicle, they probably wouldn't worry too much about it because there's not a lot of people stepping on it and whatnot. They probably step over it to get in it. And I like that root beer color, so I may just leave mine alone. I still haven't really decided what I want to do with those. But I can show you that the hood, with its neat looking chrome trim, and I use the larger bird hood ornament. That looks really nice as it is. And then we've got our body here, which just is a mild friction fit right over the top. We can look in through the back door and see that dashboard. Now, Revell has you glue the windshield to the top of the dashboard and then slide them both in. But of course, I wanted to detail them separately and get it in there. We're never going to see much of that dashboard ever again, but you did see me detail it in the video itself, and I worked it out that way. Then to attach it inside the body, I ran a bead of more Mod Podge, which is what I use to attach the glass. And every single video, even though I've shown it in hundreds and hundreds of videos, I use Mod Podge, that's what I'm saying, and I glue it. I use it to glue all the glass parts in because it dries crystal clear and very shiny. Then I use the same type of adhesive to glue the dashboard into the bottom of the windshield. I did not want to use super glue or gel. I didn't want to wait for window glue from the model companies to dry. I don't have 2 days to wait for that to harden up and everything. The Mod Podge in a food dehydrator set at 100 degrees dries in about 20 minutes. That's all it takes. So that's how I attach that. We've got the body ready to go, detailed the windshield, and then used a little silver to add in the windshield wipers that are lightly molded in. We got our rear door, attached the glass the exact same way. We got the chassis, the engine, and everything all together. I did that in the video so you could see the engine, but that is tough looking. That is real, real tough looking. I black washed the top of the carburetors and then rubbed a little more Molotow pen on top of them so they were shiny. We got the 427 valve covers on there. I went with a bronze style intake. I painted the radiator hose with kind of flecks of silver so it looked like one of those coil metal radiator hoses. The headlights just push right into place with a little more Mod Podge, no problem. Those wheel and tire package with those radial TA decals looks amazing. I noticed the rear wheels seem to sit a little forward. It does it on both. The front wheels center out, but the rear wheels seem to sit a little forward. I don't know if that's me, but I can see on the box art that one side sits a little forward and one side sits normal. So I'm not the only one that might have made that little bit of a mistake, so maybe that's just an inherent issue with the kit, but that could easily be corrected if you, you know, slide the axle back just a little bit, you'll be just fine. You would just remove the pegs on the axle, slide it in. I build these pretty quick, so I don't worry about it. I glued three of the barrels into the bed. I did not use the seats for that case because they would not sit. When the back door is open, we'll be able to see those. I left two of them out for some exterior pictures so people can see that some barrels are included. All we really have to do at this point is, and once again, showing you how easy that goes on, how nicely that grille fits on the front end and everything. That's just, I mean, that is a beautiful fit on there. We can look underneath. We see we got our glass packs, our chassis, everything's done up underneath the car. We got that big honking 427. I glued the grill in place. I glued the little side grills after doing a brown wash so it matched the vehicle. I've got to put my bumpers on. I got to put a license plate frame on. Somewhere in here is the tail light. There is some bumper lights to go on. There is a side view mirror and a tail light. So we have to put all that stuff on the car and then use the decals of your choice to decorate your sedan delivery. I'm going to get all that done. As you can see, that should all go quite easily. It's just the mounting locations for those bumpers is enormous. So that shouldn't be much of a fight. We'll get the tail light mounted on the back of the body. We'll slide it all together, get the decals on, brush on a couple coats of future floor polish to shine it up, and we'll be set to go. You can see the interior. I did not do anything too fancy with it. We'll be able to see the back, and I like the cargo bed done in that same root beer color. The front seats were done in that nice brown, and with the Krylon paint, we can see those nice crevices with the black primer. Put the shifter in, painted the pedals black, but you're not going to see hardly any of that through the windows, only if you leave the back door open all the time. So did it very basic on the interior for a show rod. I'm going to finish it all up and be right back. Isn't she a beauty? A lot of times I like to copy the box art because they come up with such cool ideas. And this one here, absolutely awesome sauce. So I wanted to copy it. What I wanted to do was try to get a closer. This is kind of a goldish, gorgeous color. I wanted to get more of a root beer color. The box art builds. The guy that builds these, beautiful job on his box art, used a little bit of a darker tone as well. That would look really cool. I wanted to go with a lighter root beer kind of a tone, a metal flake on that, and make it look nice. And then I went with a little bit of a lighter ivory on the top, and I think that color combo is really, really tough. Love the wheel and tire package on there with the BF Goodrich radial TAs. Got so many cool logos. The root beer logos, it's got the Kentucky barrel logos in two different styles, and it's got Pop's Ice Cream, which is another super cool. You could put the visor on or leave it off. I decided to put it on, and I copied the box art where it was chromed all the way across and just had a lovely time with the build. I did do the last two or three ribs in chrome on the edge just to accent some of the chrome details on the car. It's not overloaded with chrome, and I hate when it's over chromed on a car that wasn't that much chrome to begin with, but that's everybody's choice. But I did the chrome in the vents just like it was on the box art, did the left the bumpers chrome, and then use my Molotow pen to enhance just the outer edge of the running boards, which allows me to leave it body color on the inside, and then it looks pretty darn cool without looking like a big flat slab like everyone would be expecting it to be, black or some traction material. But remember, this is a car show car to me, and that's how I built it up. So the door opens up in the back. We got the barrels in there. It's got a great looking dashboard, even though you don't get to see much of it. The engine is absolutely gorgeous in this model. Builds up super easy, and we can pull the hood off. Everything just lines up. It just goes together nice, and I had such a good time building it. The decals lay down. The only thing you need to know about the decals is let them soak in hot water a little bit longer. Once you start to see the decal lift off the paper, or you see it start to move on its own, then you can slide it off. They do stick a little bit longer. I've noticed that with some of the Revell stuff, and that's how I wanted to leave it. I used the bigger hood ornament, figuring car show car, gonna put the big bird on the nose and enjoy it. So I had such a nice time building this kit. 2-day build, not a challenge. I decided to go the electrical tape wraparound. You could paint those. I've done the barrels. I built the beer wagon, which I think uses the same kind of barrels, and I've used other barrels and other kits. I've drilled holes, I've spun them, I've turned them by hand, and this time I tried out some foil tape, then I tried out some black tape. I compared them, I liked the black tape more, so I went with that, removed the foil from all the rest of them, and did that. The foil that I used, you're going to ask in the comments, the foil that I used is just duct foil. It's not bare metal foil or anything. It's just duct foil. I've used it on trim on cars before. It looked all right, but I decided I wanted to go with the black, a little more subdued. The car's a little more subdued. The barrel has them in chrome, and the ones that were built for the box art are in chrome, and they look outstanding, so I decided to do a little different in the black. I really enjoyed the build. I can't say it enough, so I'm going to link in the description where you can snag yours from modelroundup.com. They will be carrying this kit when it is available. If it's not available right now, I will get the link up there as soon as pre-orders are available. As always, when you build your 39 Chevy sedan delivery, build it your way. You don't have to do the box art. You don't have to use the decals. Build it whatever way you want. But this looked so cool, and I just wanted to do the root beer one since I don't drink whiskey at all. So I wanted to do the root beer because I love it. So have a good time. Thanks for watching the workshop. Enjoy your hobby and always build just for you. Smile while you're doing it. We'll see all of you at the next review.